same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power. We welcome you to another exciting week on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. We continue to consider raising altars unto God to glory, map or remap your life, your affairs, your territory, your lands, your possessions for divine intervention and glorious turnarounds, your city, your town, your state, your nation. It can be done in Jesus' name. And it is Jehovah showing his power in manifestation by the glory to get this done. And we're looking at the revelations that came out of the place of the altar. Remember, last week we saw Jehovah Nissi clearly. He is the one that fights for us. We consider Rephidim, what happened there, Amalek and Israel fighting. So long as our hands are up as priests of God, worshiping the Lord, the glory will thunder. He will fight our battles. He will give us the deliverance. Remember in the book of Hebrews, it said, lift up the hands that hang down and the feeble knees, lift them up. He said, make straight paths for your feet. It's another way of saying the glory will remap your life and make the crooked paths straight. That's the mystery of Isaiah 40. That's the message that John the Baptist started out with in Matthew chapter 3, I believe. So you have to understand these things are consistent. Get out of your mind this Old Testament, New Testament thing. No, the natural helps us understand the spiritual. These are patterns. These are spiritual laws. If you're in a fight, worship God. If you're in a fight, praise God. Keep your hands lifted up, and the Lord will fight for you. And then when the victory comes, you know the name of God that will be revealed to you through that. Jehovah Nissi. Jehovah Jireh, we were talking about it when we ended Friday. We have to visit because we didn't finish Genesis 22 verse 9. And they came to the place which God had told him of, and Abraham built an altar there. Of course, you can't worship the Lord without an altar. And people don't understand it when you don't belong to a church. You are not under any spiritual covering. First of all, what Jesus released the fivefold ministry for will not take place in your life. Secondly, there's no altar of worship. There's no altar of worship except God has called you and given you a covenant. How can you? You can't worship by yourself in that sense. You have to come. Oh, you have a house where you bring your tithes and offerings to. Have a house where God has raised up a man. I know there are so many fake places, but if you go to a fake place, it's because you are fake. Because if you're a true son of God, God will route you to a son he raised up. And then you'll be in order. And the blessing will continue to flow. I know there are a lot of naysayers and disagreeers out there. I don't care. It doesn't matter to me because you can't produce what we have produced every day. In taking territories, in overcoming devils, in changing people's lives, all you have is talk. Listen to those of us God has sent. You will experience miracles in your life. Amen and amen. He built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac, his son. That was the incredible thing that came out of Friday. He bound Isaac. How could you bind a teenager? And he would let you bind him because of God? Oof, where would you even find the parents that would go along, let alone get to the children? Bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here am I. And he said, lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me. Hallelujah. That is the fear of the Lord. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son. Of course, And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. Ooh, I remember teaching this in church. He says, in the mount of the Lord. I said, the only reason the revelation of Jehovah and his power, it doesn't come to a generation, is that we don't ascend the mountains of God. You just stay within the confines of the comfort zone. You don't segment yourself. You don't consecrate. You don't pursue him until he gives you his terms of endearment, if you please. Come on, beloved, the worship of God has remained the same. Jehovah Jireh. So when men have not offered a sacrifice that moves God, and we are claiming Jehovah Jireh, my provider, he shall supply all my needs. How? You have made no sacrifice. You haven't even kept the least of the covenants of God in tithing and offerings, and people are debating all these things. When you love God, this is so beneath me to even think that a tithe is an issue. Whew, I can't even imagine it. We're dealing with sowing major seeds, and people are doing first fruit and moving on to greater things in God, while other people are caught in the periphery and mired in the quagmire of unbelief and with no miracles. Jehovah Jireh, he will show himself mighty when you ascend the mountains of God and give him the sacrifice he has ordained. May the Lord open your eyes and bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. I have to move on to the next one, Jehovah Shalom, as we go into tomorrow. God bless you. We'll see you. Bye-bye.